Hi friends, it's Erica. Welcome back to my channel. So today, as you can tell by the title, I'm going to be telling you guys about some of the things that I've currently been loving. I love making these videos because I get to share some of my favorite things with you guys. Hopefully you guys can discover something new today and check it out, and maybe you'll even love it as much as I do. I really hope you guys enjoy this video. I recommend grabbing a snack or a beverage or something because I'm just going to be talking. Just having a convo with you guys, like you're all my friends. If you're not subscribed yet, please make sure to do that and also turn on the notification button so you know whenever I post a new video. I also have Instagram and Snapchat, so those are always gonna be linked in the description box. Without further ado, I hope you guys enjoy this and let's get right into the video. All right, so I'm just gonna get straight into it and I'm gonna start with the fashion category. So I only have one fashion favorite today and it's kind of random, but I've been wearing this a little bit too much lately. I have currently been obsessed with this hoodie that I got about a month ago, I think, at Urban Outfitters. It is so soft. Like, I don't know if you can tell. It's 100% polyester. This is so soft, you guys. Like, I can't even describe it. It's funny because I wasn't even looking for a jacket at the time when I was in Urban Outfitters this one day, and I was actually debating between this and then like a bodysuit, and I ended up getting this. But I'm really happy that I did because I've been wearing this so much lately, especially now that it's like really cold outside. It's sunny, but in the morning there is literally ice on the roofs and on my car windshield. Yeah, honestly, kind of a random favorite, I know, but I'm gonna have it linked below. I think they have more colors too. Yeah, hopefully it's still available, but I got a size medium. It is cropped, like I said, and it has like a little drawstring thing that you can tighten so that it like fits better, or you can wear it like loose as well. This is my current fashion favorite. Next, I have a beauty product that I want to share with you guys, and this is something that my best friend Grace actually got me for, I think it was my birthday. It is a new highlighter. I've been using the Becca highlighter in Champagne Pop for like over a year now, so I was really excited to get a new one, and this is the Anastasia Amrezy highlighter. It's the collaboration they did with Amrezy, I guess. This is gorgeous. It is like literally so pretty. I'm sure you guys can see that. I'm not someone who's super into makeup, you know, but I feel like highlight is just such a essential part of like a makeup routine. So, love this. Next, I want to talk about books. So I just have one book. The book that I've been obsessed with recently is this one. It is called Women Who Run With the Wolves. And I've actually had this book sitting on my bookshelf for about a year because I got it for Christmas last year. I've had it for a while and I'm just now reading it. All of a sudden, I just started seeing like this book, like quotes from it or just like things relating to it. They just started appearing in my life. So I was like, maybe I should read that book now. That happens to me quite often, honestly, where like all of a sudden I get these like signs to read a certain book and I end up having it already, or I end up finding it super easily at a bookstore, just like, I don't know. So I listen to those signs. Guys, this book is just incredible. Like, the author just writes in such a beautiful and poetic way, and she's a storyteller, basically. She's telling stories based off of the wild woman archetype. Let me just read you guys one of my favorite quotes because I read this and I was like shook. I hate that word, but I just used it, so great. A woman's issues of soul cannot be treated by carving her into a more acceptable form as defined by an unconscious culture, nor can she be bent into a more intellectually acceptable shape by those who claim to be the soul bearers of consciousness. Like, listen to that a couple times. I had to reread it a few times, but like, wow, so good. Check this book out if you get a chance. Okay, next I want to talk about podcasts. So I have two favorite podcasts that I've currently been obsessed with. The first one is The Elevator Podcast with Britt and Tara. Their podcast is all about spirituality and different types of mindfulness topics. They also talk a lot about Kundalini yoga, which is something that I'm really looking into right now. Maybe in the next favorites video, I'll be talking about Kundalini yoga. If you like those types of podcasts, I highly recommend The Elevator Podcast. It is so good. The next podcast I've been listening to is the Wayne Dyer Podcast. While he physically is no longer with us, his legacy that he's left behind has been so impactful on my life, and I feel like so many other people's lives. So basically, I found this podcast on Spotify where it's him and he's talking to people who have called in through like a radio, I'm pretty sure. You know, they tell him their situation and then he gives them his best advice. And I have found it just so helpful. And even though he's giving advice to like those people for their situations, it still resonates with me in a lot of ways. I highly recommend giving that podcast a listen. Moving on to the music that I've been listening to lately, my queen Maggie Rogers released her album, and literally, guys, oh my god, how many times have I said literally? I don't know. One of my favorite songs by Maggie Rogers is Falling Water. I love that song so much. Now I'm also obsessed with her new song called Overnight. I'm gonna play you guys a little part of it. Another album that recently came out is Mike Posner's album. So his album is called A Real Good Kid. And Mike Posner, you guys, has had this huge transformation. Like, I don't know if you guys have noticed or if you keep up with him, but a few months back he was on the School of Greatness podcast with Lewis Howes, and their conversation was just so mind-blowing to me. Like, he has gone through this spiritual like transformation, and it is so cool and like awesome to see. This new album is really a reflection of that, which I totally love. And yeah, his words are very powerful in the music he's created, and I highly recommend you all listen to it. I know at the beginning of the album he says that he really wants people to listen to it without any distraction and just straight through. Listen to Noah's Ark for sure. I am walking down a road of epiphanies. Three words, growth over consistency. So that song is very good. So those are all the songs that I'm going to share with you guys today, but I will link my January playlist down below in case you guys want to hear some more of the songs that I've been listening to lately. The last category is going to be TV, what I've been watching. It's January, which means The Bachelor has begun, and that show is definitely my guilty pleasure. Like, that is one of the only reality shows that I keep up with. But yeah, so I've been watching The Bachelor. My favorite gal so far is Cassie. Love her. She's kind of low-key right now in the beginning of the season. And now another show that I've been watching, I'm about to finish. I have 2 episodes left. I feel like everybody else binge watched it in a day, but it's the show You that's on Netflix. I personally think it's so good. It's just really well done, like the whole dialogue and everything. I think it's really good. I think it points out a lot of things that most people resonate with, even though they might not want to admit it. It's kind of intense. The first episode I was like, okay. Alright guys, so that is going to conclude this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it and learned about something new today. Thank you all so much for watching. Be sure to subscribe if you are not already. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.